Hello everyone, we'll be learning a topic in discrete mathematical structures, subject code 18CS36, and I'll be teaching a topic in module 4, that is principles of counting. The topic name is derangements. Myself, Dr. Madhura, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Mathematics, Sai Vidya Institute of Technology, Bengaluru. First, let us see the definition for derangements. It is a permutation of n objects in which none of the objects is in its natural place or the original place. So it's a concept of arrangement, permutation, that is arrangement of n objects. And we will see to it that none of the objects are in its original place. And that's the derangement. Example, permutation of n distinct objects, 1, 2, 3, etc. up to n, in which 1 is not in the first place, 2 is not in the second place, etc. n is not in the nth place, is a derangement. So the number of possible derangements of n distinct objects is usually denoted by dn, and it is given by dn equal to n factorial into summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1 power k divided by k factorial. On expansion of the summation, we obtain n factorial into 1 minus of 1 by 1 factorial plus 1 by 2 factorial minus 1 by 3 factorial, etc. up to 1 by n factorial. Alternate positive negative. Let us note this point. Summation k equal to 0 to 7 minus 1 power k divided by k factorial is approximately 0.36786. And using the exponential expansion, this is approximately equal to e power minus 1. So this is helping for us to write down the formula, that is n greater than or equal to 7. Then the summation value is 0.3679 or approximately e power minus 1. So dn can be rewritten as n factorial into e power minus 1 for n greater than or equal to 7. So if a value of n is less than 7, then we use the formula dn is n factorial into the summation minus 1 power k divided by k factorial. If n is a large value, then it becomes very tedious to expand the summation and obtain the answer. So for such cases, we can use the exponential expansion, and using that, dn can be written as n factorial into e power minus 1. This is a valid formula for all n greater than or equal to 7. So let us see problems on derangements. Firstly, find the number of derangements of 1, 2, 3, 4 and list all such derangements. So there are four numbers given for us, 1, 2, 3, 4. We should find the arrangement, number of arrangements in such a way that 1 is not in the first place, 2 is not in the second place, 3 is not in the third place and 4 is not in the fourth place. So first we need to find how many such arrangements exist, and later we have to list all of them. So let's see how to do. We have the formula for dn for n less than 7, n factorial into summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1 power k divided by k factorial. Substituting n equal to 4, this is 4 factorial into summation k equal to 0 to 4 minus 1 power k by k factorial. Let us expand the summation taking the xk value from 0 to 4. So when k is 0, we get 1. When k is 1, we get minus 1 by 1 factorial. K equal to 2, we get 1 by 2 factorial up to 1 by 4 factorial. The last value of k taking is 4. So simplification or using a calculator, we get d4 equal to 9. So there are 9 such arrangements such that each of the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 are not in its original place. Now let us list all such arrangements. So the arrangements are in this manner. 1 should not be in the first position. So the first positions I have tried first occupying 2. So starting with 2, then 1 can be there in the second position. 4 is in the third position. 3 is in the fourth position. Similarly, 2, 4, 1, 3 is another arrangement. We'll observe that 2 is not in the second position. 4 is not in the fourth position. 1 is not in the first position, as well as 3 is not in the third position. So every such arrangement that we are writing down, we should take care that each of these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 are not in their original positions. That is, it is satisfying the definition for derangement. So another such arrangement is 2, 3, 4, 1. These are three different arrangements starting from 2. Similarly, starting with the number 3, these are the arrangements that can arise. 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 1. Again, you observe that each of these numbers are not in its original place. We are assuming in such a manner that this is first place, second place, third place, and the fourth place. So observe 3 is not in the third position, 1 is not in the first position, 4 is not in the fourth position, and 2 is not in the second position. So these are the three more arrangements starting with 3. Similarly, I've written the arrangements starting with 4. So 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1, 4, 3, 1, 2. Of course, we should not have any arrangement starting with 1. If it is starting with 1, then it is not satisfying the definition of derangement. So 9 such arrangements are written for you. Let us see another problem. Find the number of derangements of the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, where the first three numbers are 1, 2, and 3 in some order. List all such derangements. Let us understand the question properly. We are not finding the number of arrangements or the derangements of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We are not finding D6 here. We are trying to keep the first three numbers as 1, 2, 3 itself, but it should be in some order. When the word comes as some order, we will take care that we are derranging the numbers. That 1 is not in the first position, 2 is not in the second position, and 3 is not in the third position. So, number of derangements of 1, 2, 3 in some order is D3. It is a derangement of these three numbers. And now the remaining numbers, that is 4, 5, 6. Obviously, 4, 5, 6 should be in the next three positions. So I have to look into derangements of 4, 5, 6. So number of derangements of 4, 5, 6 will also be D3, because there are three numbers considered, 4, 5, and 6. And they should be occupying the next three positions. In the first three positions, 1, 2, 3, in some order, so satisfying the derangement, it is D3. Similarly, 4, 5, 6 in the fourth, fifth, and sixth position, such that 4 is not in the fourth position, 5 is not in the fifth position, 6 is not in the sixth position. So taking care, even this is D3. So total number of derangements of the given numbers, where the first three numbers are 1, 2, 3 in some order, will be the product of these two. That is D3 into D3. 2 into 2, which is equal to 4. And that's because D3 from the definition is 3 factorial into summation k equal to 0 to 3 minus 1 power k divided by k factorial. And on expansion of the summation, we get simplifying D3 equal to 2. So that is why we have substituted here 2 into 2, so 4. So there are 4 such arrangements such that the first three numbers are 1, 2, 3 in some order. Now, let us list all such derangements. So the list will be something like this. Keep in mind that these are representing the positions for you. So I mean to say, this is the first position, second position, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. And we have found out in such a way that the numbers 1, 2, 3 should be there in the first three positions only. 1, 2, 3 should be there as the first three numbers. That is what is the given condition. So 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. With this 2, 3, 1, I have made an arrangement as 5, 6, 4. With the same 2, 3, 1, there can be another arrangement 6, 4, 5. The entire particular row, what you are seeing here, is one such arrangement. I mean to say 2, 3, 1, 5, 6, 4 is one such derangement satisfying the given criteria. 2, 3, 1, 6, 4, 5 is the second derangement. 3, 1, 2, 5, 6, 4 is the third derangement. And finally, 3, 1, 2, 6, 4, 5 is the fourth derangement. So we see that there are only 4 such derangements arising. So take care that 1, 2, 3 are in the first three positions only, so that 4, 5, 6 are in the next three positions. Of course, each of these numbers satisfying the derangement definition. That is, none of the numbers are in their original place. None of the numbers are in their original place. Next, question number 3. For the positive integers 1, 2, 3, etc. up to n, there are 11,660 derangements where 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 appear in the first 5 positions. What is the value of n? We'll try to understand this question reading it once again. There are totally n numbers, n positive integers given, and the total number of derangements of these n numbers is 11,660. But we are not deranging those n digits. There is a restriction also that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the digits 1 to 5 appear in the first 5 positions. So what is the value of n? We need to find out for what value of n, with the restriction that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 appear in the first 5 positions, we are having totally 11,660 derangements. So let us do the solution. The integers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 can be deranged in the first 5 places in D5 ways. So 1 to 5 has to be deranged, no? So that is why it is total number of derangements is D5. Then the remaining n minus 5, there are totally n numbers. So remaining will be n minus 5 integers, and whose arrangement or derangement can be written in the form Dn minus 5 ways. Dn minus 5 ways. The restriction was given in the question that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 should appear only in the first five positions. So that is the reason the integers 1 to 5 derangement we have to take separately, and remaining integers derangement we have to consider separately. Therefore, number of derangements is equal to d5 into dn minus 5. Product rule arises because both has to happen. It is not only in the arrangement of 1 to 5 in the first 5 positions, remaining integers also is to be arranged. So it's a product of these two, d5 into dn minus 5. And from the data, this is given equal to 11,660. Now, dn minus 5 is equal to 11,660 divided by d5. We can find out d5 using the formula from the definition of derangement. It is n factorial into summation k equal to 0 to n minus 1 power k divided by k factorial. Here we are taking n equal to 5, so d5 equal to 5 factorial into summation k equal to 0 to 5 minus 1 power k by k factorial. On expanding the summation, we will get this. And on simplification using a calculator, we can obtain d5 value equal to 44. So we have substituted d5 here as 44. And on simplification, we are getting dn minus 5 is equal to 265. Now to find the value of n, we use dn equal to n factorial into e power minus 1 for n greater than or equal to 7. See, the arrangement of total number of arrangements that has been given from the data is a huge value, 11,660. So we can just make sure that there are totally more than 7 numbers existing. That is the n value, whatever the answer we'll be getting is obviously more than 7. And that is the reason we are considering the formula for dn as n factorial into e power minus 1. So substituting in place of n, we can take n minus 5 and rewrite the formula for dn minus 5 as n minus 5 factorial into e power minus 1. But dn minus 5 we have already obtained as 265. So we can just rearrange the expression and write it down. N minus 5 factorial is dn minus 5 into e power 1. Dn minus 5 we have obtained as 265 into e power 1, and this is approximately 720. So if n minus 5 factorial is 720, this can be written as 6 factorial. And on simplifying this, n minus 5 is 6, or n value is equal to 11. So we were asked to find out the value of n with the condition that the n distinct integers, positive integers, are arranged in such a way that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 appear in the first 5 positions. Total number of derangements was given, which was 11,660. And using the concept of derangements, we obtained n value as 11. Next, we'll see another problem. A statement problem given to us, which can be converted to the concept of derangement. So let's see how to do it. There are 8 letters to 8 distinct people to be placed in 8 different addressed envelopes. So there are totally 8 letters, and it has to be distributed to 8 distinct people, and they are placed in the 8 different addressed envelopes. We need to find the number of ways of doing this such that at least one letter reaches to the right person. So here comes the derangement concept, because at least one letter has to reach to the right person. So no other, the remaining of the envelopes are not reaching to the actual person. So each object is not in its original place. In that manner, we can understand, which is nothing but the concept of derangement. So let us see the solution for this. the number of ways of placing 8 letters in 8 envelopes is 8 factorial. So first we are trying to put the arrangement. We are trying to do the arrangement of those 8 letters and we are trying to place it in the 8 envelopes, which is nothing but 8 factorial. And the number of ways of placing 8 letters in 8 envelopes such that no letter is in the right envelope will be the derangement. So we are trying to place the 8 letters in 8 envelopes with the condition that no letter is in the right envelope. None of the letters are in its actual envelope that is to be placed. So it comes the derangement concept, which can be done in D8 ways. So therefore, number of ways placing 8 letters in 8 envelopes such that at least one letter reaches the right person is 8 factorial minus D8. So at least one of the person has to get the right envelope or it has to reach to the right person. So total number of arrangements of those 8 envelopes in then minus of the derangements of those 8 letters. So 8 factorial minus D8 will give you the answer. Let us simplify this. D8 will be 8 factorial into e power minus 1. We are using the generalized formula for all n greater than or equal to 7. On simplifying this using a calculator, it is approximately 25,487. One last problem I would like to consider. All problems on derangements will be very small and will be very easy to understand. Only that you have to analyze the data properly, which will help you to proceed with the problem. The next question that I would like to consider is this. 7 books is distributed to 7 students for reading. So you are trying to distribute 7 books to 7 distinct students for reading. And the books are collected and redistributed. So we are collecting back the books and we are trying to redistribute the books. In how many ways can the 2 distributions be made such that no student will get the same book in both distributions? So first time when we are doing the distribution, we need not think which book is given to which student. Less commonly, we can distribute the 7 books to 7 students, and that can be done in 7 factorial ways. Usual arrangement. The second time when we are distributing the books, we have to take care that the student who had got the previous book is not getting the same book once again. So there comes the derangement concept. Right? So let us solve this problem. First time, the distribution of 7 books to 7 students can be done in 7 factorial ways. So as I said, it is the permutation of 7 books to 7 students. So it is 7 factorial ways. The books are collected and we have to redistribute the books. So number of ways of redistribution such that no student gets the same book will be the derangement. So that can be done in D7 ways. And finally, the number of ways of the 2 distributions. You are making 2 times the distribution such that no student gets the same book in both the distributions. So product rule arises. It is 7 factorial into D7 ways. Product rule arises because 2 times you are doing the distribution. Of course, it is one after the other. So first time, without any restriction, we are just distributing 7 books to 7 students. So 7 factorial ways. But second time, when we are collecting back and doing the redistribution, we need to take care that the student is not getting the same book once again. So book which was there in the first time position, it should not be placed on the same position. In that way, we can understand. So that is D7 ways. So when it comes to total number of derangements, it is 7 factorial into D7 ways. Both distributions is considered. So for D7, we are using the formula 7 factorial into e power minus 1. And this on simplification gives us 93,44,726. Hope these many problems were sufficient to understand the concept of derangements for all of you. And I've given some practice questions to you so that you can practice these questions, which will give you more clarity on the topic. Thank you for watching.